Warning. The show you're about to see contains material unsuitable for children and questionable among most adults. Viewer discretion is advised.
Nate Fernald!
Hey, Dracula, how's it going,
Hello.
Man?
Hello!
Hello, hey.
Thank you so much for being on my show tonight.
Oh, thanks for having me on your show tonight. I'm a big fan. I'm so glad to be here.
Are you drinking a cup of coffin?
No, it's just water, dude. Just water. It's not holy water, though. Don't worry.
What?
It's not holy water.
I have a hunch that this will be one of our best shows.
I'm so excited. I can't wait.
Bye.
Bye.
See you on the set.
See you on the set, dude. I like that guy.
Hey! What's up, buddy? What's up, pal?
Frankenstein, man. How are you, dude?
Good. How are you?
Oh, I'm great. Can't be better.
Hey, man, I can't wait to have you on the show tonight.
Wait. Frankenstein Tonight is tonight?
Yeah, Frankenstein Tonight's tonight, and you're the guest. You're on it, my man.
Oh, yeah. Cool.
Come on, you're a comedian.
I'm excited. I can't wait.
What have you been up to lately?
You know me, man. Getting paid, getting laid, right?
And I'm the monster?
Here we go.
Okay.
Here we go. Oh, God. I'm booked on 2 shows in 1 night. I gotta call my agent. Hey, Tim Tam. Yeah, it's your client, Nate Fernald. Fernald. Nate Fernald. F-E-R-F. F. F as in Frank. Frank as in Frank Caliendo. Yeah, Frank Caliendo is in Mad TV. Okay, Mad TV is in the show on Fox that rivaled SNL for a little while. Yeah. E-R. Yeah, as in the show E-R. Yeah, N-A, kind of like as in not applicable, but like no slash in the middle. No slash as in the current lineup of Guns N' Roses. Yeah, L-D. Fernald, your client. You know what? I'll figure it out. All right, 2 shows in 1 night. What am I gonna do? I think I got just the idea.
Tonight is the special without Brett Davis! Appearing tonight, Nate Fernald! Musical guest, Charly Bliss! Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Dracula!
Where is the microphone?
Welcome to Frankenstein's Master.
But also upsets you. Now, I've been called a lot of things in my day. I've been called a monster, a creature, a demon. But I've never been called a liberal. We're going to get to some of these issues. Now, hey, I say it every week. Hey, you may not agree with my opinions, but you got to respect that they're mine. Well, let's get the show started. Oh, Frankenstein, Frankenstein, what's going on in his Frankenstein mind? The nation's in stitches, I got a bolt in my neck. Welcome to Frankenstein Tonight. Guys, I got a bolt in my neck. Why is that? Well, there's a lot of things going on out there that are really, you know, sticking deep in my craw, as they say. Well, let's kick it off with the segment we start every show with. The top 3 things that put a bolt in my neck. Let's get down to it. Top 3 things put a bolt in my neck. Number 1, still topping the charts week after week, The Homeless. Yeah, get out of the way. Get in a home. Homeless, find a home and get inside of it. I mean, who's the monster here? You know what I'm saying? Get in a home. Again, you may not agree with my opinions, but you gotta respect that they're mine.
Please.
I have a solution for the homeless. It's a little contraption I've been building. It's called a catapult. Load them in there, send them off. Frankenstein. Number two, thing that really sticks in my craw. Planned Parenthood. You know, every week I go to the library, I'm seeing all these liberals, little parrots behind their laptops. Ah, me. And just passing memes around, passing stats. Sounds like something went down with Planned Parenthood. Yeah, you're not funded. You're not funded. You're not funded. You know what I'm saying? Planned Parenthood. Now, one of these stats that have been passed around is this pie chart. It's saying, oh, well, we only do this much percent is abortions, this much percent is STDs, this much percent. Yeah, I got a pie for you, liberals. I got a pie. It's called a cream pie. Up in your face. Pie in your face. You're all getting pie. Number three thing that really puts a bolt in my neck. It's it's the men of ISIS. Now, as we know, these men have been on an absolute rampage. They've been destroying artifacts, been destroying history, culture, raping and pillaging every village they've come into. But at the end of the day, I gotta say, you gotta respect that these guys stick together and work for a common goal. I think we could take a page out of their book and maybe apply it to some things back home here. I'm Frankenstein. That's what's going on in my mind. You know what I'm saying? Now, there was a runner-up that we didn't quite get to because it is only the top three things that put a bolt in my neck. A close runner-up to ISIS was animals that are not in zoos. I think all animals should belong in the zoo. I saw a deer the other day and I was like, get in a zoo. What are you doing frolicking over there? Get inside the zoo so we can appreciate you, so we can contain you. About to carry around some cream pies, maybe pop some pies in all these deer's faces, all these animals. I've seen birds flying willy-nilly up in the sky. Get them in a zoo. Contain them. Had enough of that. Really puts a bolt in my neck. These birds I'm seeing. These deer I'm seeing. There's other animals. Those are the two that come to mind that I saw most recently. Really puts a bolt in my neck. Now, we got a great guest for you today. But before we get to that,
I do not like.
We'll get to him right after these commercials. Let's be with you in a second.
Especially Stan.
Frankenstein tonight, everyone. Frankenstein tonight.
They are bad for my heart. We've got a great show for you tonight.
Yes.
But first, it's our segment, Joke of the Week, with Count Jokes.
Yes.
Drag me to my spot, Renfield.
Oh, yes.
Thank you. Thanks, Dracula. Oh. Renfield. So, we got Dracula here tonight, but... you know, what's really great is the mummy is directing this episode, and I figured that out when I heard someone backstage say, that's a wrap. I love this crowd.
Count Jokes, what is your joke of the week?
Well, you know, I heard that Dracula was on this episode, but the mummy was directing it.
You are so funny, Count Jokes.
Every time, it's a pleasure.
I would love to make you live forever.
Yes, forever.
But I feel like you'd be too much to eat. I'm sorry. That was an impolite thing to say. Redfield, shame yourself to him. Renfield will shame himself to you. Today we will do some sort of pranks. Pranks on you, pranks on Renfield here, and pranks on my guest. Please welcome, he is a comedian from Brooklyn, New York. Welcome, Nate Fernald!
I love this crowd!
Hey. Hi.
Have a seat.
Yes.
How are you, Nate?
I'm good. How are you?
Did you fly in from Brooklyn?
I did not.
I just flew in from Transylvania.
Yeah. How is any part of you tired?
My wings are tired. We brought you on this show because comedians are good at pranks.
Yeah, I love a good prank.
Have you done any pranks in your life?
I have. I like the classic prank where you put a rubber band around the faucet on the sink, and then when someone goes to turn it on, they get all wet. Really, really messes with your day. Getting water all over you.
What are those things?
What things?
The things you speak of, what are they?
A rubber band and a faucet?
Proceed.
Okay, well, a rubber band is, it's kind of like a rope. But
I have a prank.
Yeah?
Hey, Renfield, how are you feeling today?
I'm very hungry. Do you have any bugs?
I think I saw some.
Oh, yeah, wait.
Over there.
Oh, yeah. Master, where are the bugs?
There are no bugs, you will starve.
Oh, Master, no.
Nate.
Yeah.
Do you think that you are unprankable?
I'd like to think so. I'm pretty aware of what's going on in my surroundings. So, you know, it's kind of hard to prank me. I've been around the block when it comes to pranks.
Keep talking for a moment.
Okay, I guess, you know, I've been pranked a lot in my days. When I was a young boy, my brother, it's called pantsing. He would pull my pants down. He did it at a house party my mother had once, and it was very embarrassing because of No, Dracula, no, I don't want to be a vampire. I don't want to be a vampire yet.
Oh. Make fun!
Yes! Yes, master!
You got fooled!
I did. I feel like a stupid idiot right now.
Idiot? Yes.
Tell me, I heard you're releasing a new album.
I do, yeah, I am. I have a new album coming out. It's called Trim the Fat, and it's the first stand-up comedy album that's gonna be just punchlines. No setups. Personally, I think that most stand-up comedians are wasting our time by giving setups to jokes. It's just a space filler. We don't need it. If your punchline is good enough, you don't need a setup for it. I brought some of my punchlines with me, and here's a sampling of what you get on my album. Hey, if I wanted to get my butt sucked, I never would have dropped out of college. You know, you don't need the setup. Just you go straight to the punchline. Or, you know, maybe like, and I said to him, you keep the baby, I'll take the pizza. It's great punchlines.
My first job out of vampire college was working at a record factory.
Yeah?
I was the one that bit the holes in the center.
Ah! Are your fangs sharp enough to like spin a record in
Tell
your mouth
me.
And play? It's it. Okay.
What is Spider-Man tweet?
Oh, Spider-Man tweet. It was a great tweet. I made a great tweet about the Spider-Man franchise being relaunched again, and I had a big campaign to get this tweet as many retweets as possible, and we got the thing to over 1,500 retweets. But then it was recently announced that the new Spider-Man franchise will not be a retelling of Peter Parker's backstory, and it really messed up my original joke, so I really need everyone to unretweet the tweet now. I've been on a campaign to get all 1,500 plus of these people to unretweet it, because I can't have this tweet out there. I just can't have that out there anymore like this. And, you know, people have asked me, hey, you know, why don't you just delete it? And I just don't have time. I don't have the time. So I've been messaging all these people individually, trying to get all 1,500 of them to unretweet it, because I just don't have the time to delete it. So if you retweeted it, please unretweet it.
I do not know what you're talking
about.
Yeah,
well, you can learn about it at natefernald.com/Spider-Man tweet. You can get the whole history. We've had a lot of celebs retweet this thing. There's a video about when I went to Hawaii and discovered myself and realized we needed to take the thing down. So check it out. There's a lot of important info. And please, we got to get this thing back down to zero retweets. It's very important that we do this. It's very important.
Hey!
Yeah.
Do you have any food?
I don't. I'm sorry.
Are you sure?
I'm very positive.
He's looking at me like... Whoop, nope.
Let's get those retweets! On tweet!
Yeah.
I have a real beef with Peter Parker.
Yeah? What's the beef?
You know why?
Why? Why is your beef?
I am the original Batman.
Well, Spider-Man's a Spider-Man.
Spiders?
And he's from the Marvel universe, whereas Batman is from the DC universe.
Nate Fernald.
Yes.
You make many memes. What are they?
A meme is, I think meme, it is something that holds the most cultural importance in our society. It's just a way of encapsulating something very important and just getting it out there on the internet.
And where do you get your ideas from?
You know, Dracula, I'd really love to answer that question for you, but,
Proceed!
But first, I gotta take a dump.
And welcome back to Frankenstein Tonight. Can I be frank with you for a minute? Frankenstein, that is. Guys, we're gonna kick it into a segment where we're gonna be asking callers to call in. Because you've heard what puts a bolt in my neck. Now I want to hear what puts a bolt in your neck. There's a lot of things out there, so please get on those phones and dial the number. But first, to help me take these calls, I'd like to welcome our guest for the evening. He's a comedian. He's from Brooklyn. He may not agree with my views, but they're my opinions, and you gotta respect them. Please welcome Nate Fernald. Nate, thanks so much for coming on the show.
Oh, thanks for having me, Frankenstein.
Now, I know you're a comedian and probably a bit of a liberal. I mean, you look like the Verizon guy.
Funny you should say, I am currently in a Verizon ad campaign.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. Now, Nate, I'm a conservative, and, you know, I have my own opinions, but you gotta respect that they're mine.
Okay, well, you know, you could say that, but here's the thing. I have my opinions, and so let's say in a world where we have to respect that your opinions are yours, then shouldn't we also respect that my opinions, we should respect that those are mine?
Okay, and I do see your point there.
Yeah.
Let's just remember that I actually also have my opinions, and you gotta respect that those are personally mine.
Okay, but shouldn't technically, if we invert that, shouldn't you also have to respect that my opinions are mine?
Okay, and that's a great philosophy, and we're going to put that on the back burner. Okay. And just have to remind you that I have my own values and opinions, and those are personal mine.
I'm going to put a pin in that real quick, real quick, just a little pin, and say that I have my opinions, and you know, you have to respect that those are mine.
And I'm the monster?
Hey, guys,
okay, it looks like we're going to take some calls. We got Olivia. We got Olivia from Massachusetts on line one. Olivia, what puts a bolt in your neck?
When people trade my sneakers for sandals.
Damn, girl. That puts a bolt in my neck. Sneakers for sandals. Well, I only wear boots, so Nate, what do you think?
Well, who is trading your sneakers for sandals?
My family.
What is this, like, sandal market that's going down? Where is this happening?
They tell me we're going to the beach. We never get to the beach, but suddenly I've got sandals and no sneakers.
I mean, that sounds like a bad place to be. I know there is a sneakers sandals helpline out there that I think you can call. It's totally anonymous, and they will kind of help you out and talk you through that.
Great. I guess I'll look it up online then.
Great. I guess you will. You know, my things that put a bolt in my neck were the homeless. You know, they were Planned Parenthood. They were ISIS. I don't have time for sneakers and sandals. Line two, we got Aaron from Washington Heights. Aaron, what's going on?
Hey, you want to hear what put the bolt in my neck?
Yes.
Uh-huh.
When parents, when they don't allow their children to have cereals with marshmallows in them.
Yeah.
It's like, let the kids decide, you know?
Yeah.
Let the kids decide.
I think kids should be able to make all their decisions.
Yeah, I agree with that.
I think you should be allowed to get a tattoo when you're four.
Yeah, why not?
Yeah, why not? Because when
that's when your imagination is the most creative, so why wouldn't...
It is.
Yeah, and so, you know, Aaron, you seem pretty upset about this, and you also sound like you might be 40 years old.
I mean, sometimes you just hold things, you know, and you just realize how much of an effect it's had on your life.
Aaron, do you have kids?
Not currently.
Do you need a box of Lucky Charms right now, Aaron?
Wait, when you say not currently, did you have them like a day or two ago and you no longer have them, or?
I mean, it's a weird thing. I don't possess children at the moment.
Nice. When was the last time you possessed children?
It's about 4 months ago, but they weren't mine at the time.
At the time they weren't yours, did they become yours? Were they yours at a different time?
No.
How did
Aaron, we got no one else on any line. We're going to keep digging deep on this.
That's great. Yeah,
How did they get relinquished from you?
Well, their technical parents got them back.
Their technical parents.
I think that's what it's called when it's technical parents.
What would you call your relation to them?
If I just wanted to set them free.
What were these shackles they were in?
I mean, their parents weren't being good to them. They didn't let them have their freedoms. I was their tutor at first. I was tutoring them, and I just said, no, that's enough.
Speaking of that's enough, we're going to go to Francis on line three from Brooklyn. Francis, what puts a bolt in your neck?
Is this Frankenstein?
Yeah, you're talking to Frankenstein and Nate Fernald.
Hello.
Hey, guys, this is Francis. I have a question for you, Frankenstein. Long-time listener, first-time caller.
Hi, Francis.
How do you keep your skin so green?
My skin so green?
Yeah.
I hope you're not talking to me, right?
You look great, too, though, Nate. You look great, too.
He's a comedian. I can't help that. Well, me, anytime I feel my green face fading back to, you know, a pale color, I just turn on CNN, and that makes me real sick pretty quick.
Oh, boy. Well, that's all my questions. Thank you very much.
All right, Francis. Toodaloo. Looks like Olivia's back on from Massachusetts. She's probably upset that I hung up on her immediately. Olivia, what do you got for us?
Yeah, I am a little sick, but now I have another thing that puts a bolt in my neck.
Oh.
When I'm looking for my sweaters, and all I find are t-shirts.
Girl, you got problems.
You have problems with articles of clothing that are similar to the summer version of that clothing.
Yeah, well, this time, my parents said we were going on a ski trip. Great, I go to look for my sweaters, all I have are t-shirts.
Great!
Have you ever gone to look for your pants and all you find are shorts?
Yes!
Have you ever gone to look for your winter hats and all you find are big floppy sun hats?
Yes!
Have you ever put a bolt in your neck and didn't have a washer?
Yes.
Well, while you're thinking about that, Olivia, we're going to go to Larry from the Bronx.
Hi, how's it going, Frankenstein?
Good. How are you doing, Larry?
I'm all right, but I'll tell you what puts the bolt in my neck.
Yeah.
I'm really sick of this whole thing with pizza rat, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
What is up with that? What about the pizza seagull, the pizza raccoon, you know, the pizza possum? I mean, oh, come on, you know, like there's other animals. You know what I mean? I mean, doesn't it bother you that they don't get any attention whatsoever?
Yes, it does, Larry. That really puts a bolt deep in my neck.
So Frankenstein, so you're saying you're not happy with this 1% of the animals that is getting all the pizza attention right now? Do you think were the rest of the animals not deserving enough?
If you were on my show earlier, Nate, you would know that. What?
Neck?
Neck.
Think about
it. Sorry, about even monsters have Freudian slips. My bad. Live TV, it's magic. Guys,
what puts a bolt in your Nate?
Okay. And this will be the last time I have a comedian on the show. You're added to the list of things that are putting a bolt in my neck.
I'm a bit of a live wire, I know that. But.
Now, well, earlier I said that what puts a bolt in my neck are animals that aren't in zoos. So seeing a pizza rat upsets me on multiple levels. One, that he's eating food, and two, that he's not in the zoo.
You know, Frankenstein.
Yeah, you know, I didn't even think about that. You're right. None of those animals are in zoos, but they got pizza somehow.
Uh-huh. They're taking over like humans.
God. Brilliant.
Did you say brilliant?
You're brilliant, Frankenstein.
Thank you.
Absolutely brilliant. Thank you.
What about me?
Whatever, man.
Nice. Wow.
What?
Well, by the sound of that, sounds like Larry's gone forever. I think we got time for one more. We got Olga in Cincinnati. Olga, love your name. It's a very monster name.
Don't you remember me, Frankenstein?
Oh, no.
It's me, your ex-bride.
Ah!
I see that you've got your opinions and you're asking others to respect them. So you.
I guess you're just jealous that I have my own late night show. And you are still working at Quiznos.
How did you know about that?
I'm married from time to time.
And that's more than I can say about you with your little sad world of opinions you've constructed around yourself.
Olga, why don't you cut to the chase? What puts a bolt in your neck?
The fact that you are with Judith. And that she has a bob haircut. You aren't. You said you like big hair. You like long hair. I could never get over that.
Well, can I say, Frankenstein does what Frankenstein does. That's about all the time we have for calls. You know, Nate, I want to get it in. With you right now. I want to know. You're a comedian.
Yeah.
You're a funny guy. You're quick on your feet.
Mm-hmm.
Where do these ideas come from?
You know, Frankenstein, I would love to tell you that, but first, I gotta take a dump.
So many humorists over the years. You think every joke must have been told already, but no. Innovators like yourself, Nate. They come up with new concepts. Earlier today, I wrote a joke about type O. So Nick, tell me, where do you get these ideas? Do they come from you in your dreams?
Yeah. Yeah, Frankenstein, Yeah.
Well, I am not Frankenstein.
I mean Dracula. Dracula, that's what I meant.
That's
Dracula.
Right, Nick.
Listen, Dracula, I'd love to answer your question. I really would. But first, I gotta take a dump.
And we're back on Frankenstein Tonight. Oh, it looks like my guest is coming right back in, thankfully, because Nate, now that you've taken all the dumps, I really want to get down to the hard-hitting questions with you.
Yeah. Ooh, that was quite the dump, I tell you.
So please, tell me, where do these ideas come from?
You know, Frankenstein, I'd love to answer that, but before I do...
Don't tell me.
I gotta take another dump.
Well then, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for our musical guest of the evening. They're from Brooklyn, New York. They're doing a U.S. tour this November with Darwin D's. Please put your hands together for Charly Bliss. Taking my dumps.
Mister.
Dracula.
I have a real juicy prank.
Oh, I love pranks, and the juicier the prank, the better the prank.
Master.
Renfield, stop bothering me.
I'm so hungry.
I compel you to be quiet about it.
I'm so hungry.
So we have this slot, 11 p.m.
Yep.
And we have a rival on another network.
Oh, you do?
His name is Frankenstein.
Yeah, I heard Frankenstein's got a show. Yeah.
We thought it would be bloody hilarious if we pulled an old-fashioned prank on him.
Wait, you mean you want you and I to go to Frankenstein's show together and play a prank on Frankenstein. Is that...
That's a bingo!
Listen, I love pranks. You know I love pranks. But maybe we should keep our pranks to the studio here, you know? Maybe it wouldn't be a...
I pranked you! I have pranked Redfield!
You did, you pranked us,
and I'm not going
enough
to prank Mina!
Yeah,
for
yeah.
For I love her so much.
Great, yeah, and I think that's enough pranks for the night. Maybe we shouldn't go to Frankenstein's show.
We have 25 minutes to fill at Frankenstein's studio is right in this building.
Yeah, so you want us to go to Frankenstein's studio and prank him? Yeah. Hold that thought real quick. Before we get to that, Dracula, I gotta take a dump.
That's a bingo!
And he said to me, universal healthcare, more like universal monsters. Nate, welcome back. Now that you've
great jump, I just
perfect. Glad to hear it. Yeah. Well, now I really want to get into the hard-hitting questions,
hey, listen,
Nate.
Frankenstein, I heard a rumor that Dracula is thinking of coming to your show tonight and pranking you. So maybe we should just kind of end your show right now and everyone go home and, you know, we put an end to the night and everyone leaves to not have to deal with the prank.
Dracula's pranking me?
Well, yeah, he intends to tonight. It's...
How would you know that, Nate? You've only been here and or taking dumps.
I guess it was just a feeling that I got when I was taking my dumps. that Dracula, I get dump dreams. When I take these dumps, I have dreams, and they often always come true. And I had one that Dracula was going to come to your show here and prank you. So that's why I think we should just end the show.
Well, that's not.
Everyone go home. We don't want to deal with that. He's very good at pranks.
He's in the next studio over. But he could easily come over here and prank. But you know what? You know what, Nate? I haven't always been the host of Frankenstein Tonight. I used to, back in my teen years, I used to be a little prankster myself. They actually nicknamed me Frankenstein.
Wow.
Yeah. So, maybe I'll prank him before he can prank me.
So you're saying that you and I should go over to Dracula's studio and prank him?
That's precisely what I'm saying. We put our minds together. And Dracula's pranking, and they're saying,
no,
I'm the monster.
No.
I mean, what's going on
yeah,
here?
Frank, I don't think that's the best idea. I think we should just kind of end the show right now and maybe go home. No more pranks.
No. They call me Frankenstein, and Frankenstein does what Frankenstein does. You know what I'm saying?
Can I talk you out of this? Can I talk you out of this? You know what, Frankenstein? Maybe I can't talk you out of this, but I'd like to.
I don't like where these sunglasses are going, Nate.
Yeah. I'm just holding on to them in case.
You're not gonna prank Dracula with me?
I
need you there, Nate.
Of course. I mean, hey, I'm a guest on your show. I'll do what you want me to do on your show. Maybe we should take some calls instead. Maybe we should take some calls. How about instead of going to Dracula's show? Because we don't want to do that.
Fine. Let's take a call. You think long and hard about this.
Okay.
Should we or should we not prank Dracula? Somebody call. Do we have any callers out there? I mean, why wouldn't you want to prank?
Listen,
sleaziest monster in the game.
Hey.
I mean, I've seen them all. Wolfman, Mummy, Lizard Boy. I've dealt with the top monsters. He is easily the sleaziest.
Hey, don't forget Ghost.
Yeah. Never seen that guy.
Listen, hey, I'm a guest on your show. If you want to go prank Dracula, I guess I'd do that. But Let's take calls instead. This is a call-in show.
All right. You know, but it looks like we got a call on line one. Hello? Who am I speaking with? This is Frankenstein.
Hello?
It's Elodie from Cincinnati.
Prank that motherfucker.
What, motherfucker? What?
Prank Frankenstein. Prank Dracula.
Yes, that's what I'm saying, Nate.
Yeah, but hey, but what if what if the prank is that because he's probably expecting a prank, so if we don't prank him, that's the prank. You know, that's like the ultimate prank.
Yeah, I don't think that will land. You have any suggestions for what kind of prank we should pull over on old Drac?
I know what you should do. Swap his sneakers with sandals.
The old sandal sneaker swap. I'm liking where this is going. Yeah, back in my teen days, I used to do the old sweater t-shirt swap, and that would hit pretty hard in the wintertime. Yeah.
I love the old wool cap, big floppy sun hat swap. That's my favorite of the swaps.
That's a good one, too. Well, thanks for the advice. So let's take another call. Is that Matt in New Jersey? You wanna decide this for us? Should we prank Dracula?
Oh, heck yeah, you should prank him good.
Prank him good?
God, you're...
Mm-hmm.
What's the best prank you've ever pulled, Matt?
Oh, there's one that I really like. It's called the Gypsy Switch.
The Disney Switch?
The Gypsy Switch.
I like where this is going.
Oh, sure, yeah. You start the big old bowl of vanilla pudding.
I'm listening.
And basically, you eat as much of the pudding as you can, but you usually can never finish it because it's so gosh darn big.
I've been there.
And then you invite your friend over. In this case, I guess it would be the old tractor.
Love it.
And you ask him, hey, Jack, you want any pudding, right?
Perfect, because so far I haven't learned anything about gypsies or switches.
Well, now here's the real kicker. So you finally take him down to the basement where you've been keeping about 15 gypsies captive for the past 17 years.
Perfect, I have that all lined up.
And basically, you give compliments to each other while the gypsies beg and plead in a Romanian dialect that you really can't understand.
Now, keep that in mind if the sandal sneaker swap doesn't work.
I love it.
I love it, too. Thanks for calling in. We have time for one more caller. Let me check in with my producer, the mummy. Mummy, we got time for one more caller. Mummy? Okay, it looks like one more guy. We're gonna take Eric. No, let's go Morgan from Brooklyn. Psych, Eric. Morgan from Brooklyn. Morgan?
Hi.
Hi, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing fine. I mean, I got a bolt in my neck, but who doesn't?
Oh, same here, brother.
Okay.
I think you should definitely prank Dracula. I mean, he's the bad boy of, you know, like, Transylvania.
Did you say bad boy or bat boy?
Oh, man, I said bat boy, but bat boy's funnier. Yeah.
It is funnier, but yours is truer. He's a bad boy.
He is. You should definitely, definitely prank him.
Well, and do you have anything to top the sneaker sandal swap or the gypsy switch?
I don't, but my best prank ever was one time, my sister, I woke her up from a dream and I convinced her that I had died.
No, I'll keep that in mind.
Are you dead already?
Why don't we do that?
Am I dead already?
Yeah.
Honey, I'm alive.
Okay, cool.
Well, check you later, Morg.
Bye.
All right, okay, let's take one more caller. Maybe they can convince you not to prank Dracula.
All right. Paul from the Bronx, you're on the line.
Hey, Frank.
Hey, Paul.
Hey, you should prank this guy.
I should prank?
Damn it. Yeah, he's, I don't care for his program.
I like where your head's at.
Yeah, he deserves it. He's, he made the other guy slip on a banana before. It's uncalled for.
Yeah, what was up with that?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Hey, you think we should cut that mop that guy's got? That beehive?
Wait, so you're saying we should prank Dracula because Dracula pranked someone else?
Huh?
Haven't you ever heard that two pranks
don't make a stink?
Stink? Yeah.
Yeah, I've heard that.
That old saying?
I've never heard that one.
I don't care for it. I've heard it. I don't care for it.
It's an old saying.
Oh, what's your prank? What do you got?
My prank?
Yeah.
We should get the pizza rat involved.
Pizza rat's probably booked.
Yeah, he's probably booked. It's a busy week for the pizza rat.
Yeah.
He's on the, I think he's on a morning show tomorrow, yeah. So he's probably sleeping.
I'm all out of ideas.
All out of ideas. And I'm the monster! All right, thanks for calling in.
So it sounds like you're definitely gonna be.
I'm definitely going full prank.
Dracula.
I'm going full Frankenstein on this,
hey,
Nate.
Why don't you just kind of hold on to that prank for a minute, and I'll help you prank him. But first, I gotta take a dump again.
Oh, brother.
And today we are joined by a special band called Charly Bliss. Hello and welcome to my show. What is your name?
It's Rodney Carmichael.
And where are you from?
Mount Pleasant, New Jersey.
Mount Pleasant, New Jersey.
Yes, sir.
I just flew in from Transylvania. And do you have anything to plug?
Playing the Mount Pleasant Battle of the Bands this Saturday. It's gonna be great. That's
it. Ladies and gentlemen, Charly Bliss.
Old Frank. No. I think I pulled a real good one over on him. Yeah. And I'm the monster. I mean, this is getting ridiculous. Well, I think I set quite the trap in place, and it's a little better than the old sneaker shoe swap, if I do say so myself. Yep, I think I pulled a good one on old Drac. I felt pretty young back there, you know, like it in my teen days. Driving around, sipping on malts, just being a general bad boy. Yeah, I think it's safe to say Frankenstein is back in full effect. Absolutely. Now I'll just sit down and relax in my nice, comfortable chair. Yikes! Oh, yikes! Ah, fangs, are you kidding me? Is this thing on? Are you kidding me? And I'm the monster? This guy is sick. This guy is absolutely sick. Oh, I'm going to get him. I'm going to pull one over on him. Oh, hey, come on, dolls.
Jeez. Quiet, Renfield. You're being such a pest tonight.
Master.
Ouch!
What?
Redfield! My bottle! Oh, it hurts so bad! You're hurting it more, Redfield!
I'm sorry, man!
Stop touching it! Get my ointment! Redfield! That's not a bingo! I will get my revenge on that rampaging beast! Renfield!
Yes!
Find my torch!
Torch!
Light it!
Torch!
I'm going to burn this studio down!
Oh! Where's the torch?
Right,
where's the torch?
Vengeance will be mine!
Frankenstein!
Let me at him! Let me at him! What?
What?
Describe them to me.
They're your filthy fangs.
Not me. Wait a minute. You're the one that put the cross on my chair.
Oh, was I?
Oh, fuck you, Frankenstein.
Oh, fuck you.
Frank you.
Oh, fuck you.
Fuck you.
Oh, fuck you and your stupid-ass haircut.
Oh, I'm the one with the stupid-ass haircut.
Oh, and I'm the monster.
Oh, you with your lousy catchphrase. Don't touch my head. Don't touch it. You know what? You're
Dracula,
a dick.
Dracula.
Oh. A what?
Frankenstein.
Who is it?
It's me, Nate, your guest. I mean...
What?
I mean, first off, I don't know how you got here before I did, because I left before you did.
Well, I thought you were taking a dump,
I
Nate.
I mean, yeah, no, I was taking a dump.
What are you even doing here, Nate?
I just came to, for the prank, right? And...
What prank?
All right, guys. All right, fine, I've been double-timing both of you. I've been a guest on both of your shows tonight. I haven't taken any dumps tonight.
You're telling me you've been two-timing both of us?
Yeah.
And at the end of the day, I'm the monster?
Yeah, I know, yes.
What is going on, Nate?
I know. To think that I'm on stage with two literal monsters, and I'm the worst monster of all. Guys, this is really embarrassing, but I think I gotta take
it. No, you don't, Nate. No more.
No, I...
No more dumps.
No, I really do have to take
you're
a dump.
You're not going anywhere.
No, I actually for real have to take a dump this
no,
time.
You, no, you're not going anywhere.
No, I fully admit that this whole night I've been saying I had to take a dump as an excuse
pardon
to, like...
Pardon the pun, but that's bullshit.
Yes, it was, but now I actually seriously do have to take a dump. I think just saying dump all night just kind of worked it into my brain, and I think I have not gone in 4 days, and I really need to take a dump right now, so I do
I think you've dumped it.
I need to go.
Like you're going to prank us.
No, I'm not pranking anyone. I have to take the biggest dump of my life right now. I swear to God. Oh, God. Guys, you got to let me go.
What do you want to do to him, Frank?
Guys, just please. I think it's in everyone's best interest if you let me leave right now. I have to.
Permission to leave? That's like my thing, but entering.
It is. But I do.
Won't get it.
I have to take. Oh, God. It's going to happen. Guys, it's going to happen on your show if you don't let me go. I think it might happen one more time.
I mean, I gotta say it, I'm the monster!
Wait, hold on, I think it's gonna happen again. I think I might even do it one more time. God, another time! Oh, great. I fucking shit my pants on TV.
Good, well, it serves you right.
Shit my fucking pants on TV. No, this was supposed to be like my big fucking break, and I shit my pants on TV. What the fuck? Like, you know, I'm kind of like a like hot name right now in like the entertainment world, and it's like this was kind of like the thing that was going to put me onto the next level, and now I fucking shit my pants on TV. I'm going to be a fucking YouTube video tomorrow, I'm sure. Everyone's going to be just fucking viral video, and oh, comedian Nate Fernald shits his pants on TV, and then my career is over.
Well, maybe you learned a little something today about
my career.
What over spells?
I shit my pants. Oh. I just shit my pants on your fucking TV show.
Oh, fuck. That must be humiliating.
Dude, just shut up. You guys are like not even feeling bad for me right now. And you're the monster. I don't think this day could get. I don't think it could get any worse than it already has. This is the worst thing that's ever happened to me in my life. Well, so much for my career. So much for my love life, because who's gonna want to marry the man who shit his pants on TV? Certainly not Tandy or Banya or Citrella. The many women I've loved in my life.
Renfield's hungry.
None of them. What?
What? He's eating my butt! What the fuck? He's eating my butt!
Let's have a monster mash!
Monster mash!
Oh God! Oh God! Oh God! Oh God!